Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Hi, I'm Dr. Sanjeev P. Sahani, and today we will be discussing about subjective well-being. Subjective well-being is the scientific term for happiness and life satisfaction, thinking and feeling that your life is going well, not badly. People's levels of subjective well-being are influenced by both internal factors, such as personality and outlook, and external factors, such as the society in which they live. Some of the major determinants of subjective well-being are a person's inborn temperament, the quality of their social relationships, the societies they live in, and their ability to meet their basic needs. To some degree, people adapt to conditions so that over time, our circumstances may not influence our happiness as much as one might predict they would. Importantly, researchers have also studied the outcomes of subjective well-being and have found that happy people are more likely to be healthier and live longer, to have better social relationships, and to be more productive at work. In other words, people high in subjective well-being seem to be healthier and function more effectively compared to people who are chronically stressed, depressed, or angry. Thus, happiness is good for people and for those around them. According to Edward Gainer, there are three major types of happiness, which are high life satisfaction, frequent positive feelings, and infrequent negative feelings. Subjective well-being is the label given by scientists to the various forms of happiness taken together. Some people experience all three elements of happiness. They are very satisfied, enjoy life, and have only a few worries or other unpleasant emotions. Other unfortunate people are missing all three. Most of us also know individuals who have one type of happiness but not another. For example, imagine an elderly person who is completely satisfied with her life. She has done everything she ever wanted, but is not currently enjoying life that much because of the infirmities of age. There are others who show a different pattern. For example, who really enjoy life but also experience a lot of stress, anger, and worry. And there are those who are having fun but who are dissatisfied and believe they are wasting their lives. Because there are several components to happiness, each with somewhat different causes, there is no magic single cure all that creates all forms of SWB. This means that to be happy, individuals must acquire each of the different elements that cause it. In his latest book, Happiness, Unlocking the Mysteries of Psychological Wealth, Diner sums up the results from his 25 years of research on happiness. He underlines four central ingredients for a happy life. 1. Psychological wealth is more than money. It is also your attitudes, goals, and engaging activities at work. 2. happiness not only feels good, but is beneficial to relationships, work, and health. 3. It is helpful to set realistic expectations about happiness. No one is intensely happy all the time. And finally, 4. Thinking is an important aspect to happiness. His theory of attention, interpretation, and memory, which is AIM, helps people to increase their psychological wealth. That's all for today. Thank you for watching Chips Infotainment. Stay tuned for more videos. Thank you.